जय श्री गुरुदेव। आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चरल वीडियो इज टू सॉल्व अ प्रॉब्लम नंबर 27। फॉलोइंग फिगर शोज द फ्रंट एंड साइड व्यूज ऑफ सॉलिड। ड्रॉ द आइसोमेट्रिक प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ द सॉलिड। दिस इज द फ्रंट व्यू ऑफ द सॉलिड एंड द साइड व्यू। इफ यू सी द फ्रंट व्यू, इट इज अ कंटिन्यूअस डिक्लाइन, इज अ टी शेप, राइट? इज गिवन डायमेंशन 30 mm, देन 60 एंड 30 हियर। If you view from this side, now it looks as a rectangular box or this figure. And what about this also? It's a rectangular box here of dimension 30 and 60 mm. Then if you go for draw isometric projection, now by viewing these two orthographic projections, front view and side view. In the previous problems, we draw the top view and front view, right? But here we go, here in this problem directly is given front view and side view is given. Now in the front view and side view, if you go for with the from your imagination, how this object looks here, the object looks like this in three dimensional in nature, right? And remember the some points in the previous drawing, you can see that whatever the top view of the orthographic projection, that is what we draw on horizontal plane, that we show in the iso horizontal view, that is 30 degree and 150 degree line, right? The front view of the orthographic view, that we have shown in iso right view, that is 30 degree and 90 degree line. For side view of orthographic view, that we can show in iso left view, that is 90 degree and 150 degree line. This already we have discussed in the basics of construction of isometric projection of the planes and solids, right? Now you can show this the front view of this solid in iso right, means 30 degree and 90 degree line, right? Now see this here in 30 and 90 degree line, the mark the point on this measure vertical, how much here vertical is, how much is a 9, whatever the horizontal lines are there, those are considered 30 degree line in iso sheet. And vertical lines are there, consider as a 90 degree, that is a iso right view, right? Now here 30 mm is vertical line, right? Now here from the point measure 30 mm is how many, iso 30 means 3 blocks you measure here. After that, now from here to here, how much it is? 60, means on which line it is iso, on which line it is 30 degree line, right? On 30 degree line from this point measure 60 mm, iso 60 means how much? 6 blocks, 1 2 3 4 5 6, right? Then go for from this to this in vertical, the means is a 90 degree line. The 90 degree line here also is showing the 90 degree only. How much it is dimension? It is total from here to here 30 minus this is, sorry, from here to here how much? 60 minus this amount is 30. 60 minus 30, 30. 30 divided by on both sides, then 15 mm from here to here, 15 mm from here to here also, 15 mm. Now go downward 15 mm, right? Similarly, from this point also measure 6 blocks, we'll get this line. Then from this point we'll measure of 50 iso 15 mm means 1.5 mm, right? From this line again, see that this is a horizontal line, how much it is? 30 mm. Then go for iso horizontal, sorry, iso 30 mm or measure 3 blocks from the center here, 1 2 3 blocks. From here vertical, how much vertical is? 60 mm, 6 blocks we measure. From here measure 6 blocks, 1 2 3 4 5 6, right? Previously you get this part, right? From here to here again, on from here to here how much? 30 mm, iso 30, you measure it here, iso 30. Now we'll get this the front view. Front view of the solids, what shape it is? T shape, as it is T shape here, that is iso right view. Whatever the side view, side view you can show in iso left view, right? How much it is here? This from the area 30 mm. Height is how much? 60 mm. From this point, from all these corners of this point, draw a the in iso 50 degree line, draw a 30 mm from each corner of this point, right? Then you go for join this from bottom also, draw a iso 30 mm on 150 degree line. can join these points. Now we'll get the isometric projection of the T solid, right? Now similarly go for next problem. Now problem number 28. Following figure shows the front and side views of solid. Draw isometric projection of solid. Now view the front view and side view. In front view also it is a T shape. When you view the side view, now this solid is a looks as a rectangular shape. But what about this solid? This portion is, it's not a rectangle, it's a circular shape. Means it is a round rod, that's why I shown the axis line here. Right? This is a round rod. Over this here, one another rectangular block is there, right? And all dimensions are given, right? Now this block diameter is 30 mm, this is 60, this is 30, and height is how much? 60 mm is given, and width of this block is 30 mm. Then we combine this front view and side view. Now you can see this. This is the imagination, from the imagination, the solid, how it looks. Then you go for draw this. Now first you go for draw this, the first block of this one, the right, in a, where you want to draw here in ISO right view, right? Directly you can't draw this one. First you go for draw this one, right? So that is ISO, on the ISO right view. Now on 30 degree and 90 degree line, you mark the point, the 3 blocks and 6 blocks. And in side view it is almost 30 mm, right? Then construct this rectangular, okay, so actually the square prism it is, right? From then you go for mark the center point of this. Now join this, the you get the center of this in ISO left view. Then join these corners, opposite corners. Now we'll get the center of this ISO left view of this prism, right? Now after that, from this, what is the dia here? Dia is how much? 30 mm, right? The dia is 30 mm. From the center, how much it is? 15 mm from each side, right? Now from this, measure ISO 15 in vertical line. Or measure ISO 15 means how many? 1.5 blocks. Now measure ISO 15 means how much here? 1.5 blocks on vertical line. And on the, that is what is ISO left view means? ISO left view is 90 degree and 150 degree line, right? On the 150 degree line, measure 1.5 blocks that touches this one, right? Then construct this a rhombus, right? Then join the major diagonal and minor diagonal and mark the center of this rhombus. Then you go for construct the ellipse, the circle in ISO left view. That is from the minor diagonal. Take the opposite corners, then draw a line, center of the opposite edges center. Then from the minor diagonal, then opposite side center, draw a line. Then take the radius, this is the center, then this opposite corner center is the radius, draw an arc. And same thing here, this is center, draw another arc. From intersection of major diagonal and the minor diagonal, from the minor diagonal point to the opposite side, that intersection points will get the another the arc for the center, right? This is another, right? Okay, now once you construct this a semicircular, once you construct this a circular arc that shows ellipse, whatever the box is there, that you can extend towards what here in 30 degree line, right? How much distance is given here? 60 mm. Right now from this here, extend this, draw a 30 degree lines up perpendicular to this square box. Along that, measure ISO 60 or measure is 6 blocks. Then again, we'll construct one more rhombus here and join the major diagonal, minor diagonal, mark the center points, and then again draw a circular arc that shows an ellipse. Then draw a tangent to those ellipse, that is a continuous thick line. Right, this is the how we construct the problem number 28. Right, now show the only the visible lines here, the cylinder and the prism is coincide here. Don't show this line, or is it shows the dashed line or continuous thin lines. Remaining things are continuous thick line. Right, try to solve these two problems. If you have any doubt, contact to my number. Thank you for watching this video.